I've got two swords in my inventory, one sword to accelerate and one is the handbrake. When I select the first slot, I'll start moving. You'll see some particles, you'll hear my engine, and I'm moving in the same direction as I'm looking. And when I select the second slot, I'll stop moving. And as you can see, when I select the first slot, I won't move immediately. The XP bar displays your speed, and when you select the first slot, your speed will slowly increase. As you probably guessed, the moving is just a giant clock with a bunch of command blocks. Each command block tests for a different player rotation, and using some highly advanced math, I calculated the relative coordinates in which the player should be teleported. So now we'll make a new score called speed. The thing is, I'm kind of lazy and I don't want to make these command blocks for every single value there is for the speed score. So instead, we are just going to make sure the command blocks are powered more times per second when our speed is higher. So we'll add another score and we'll call this ticks. Now we'll add a command block to this clock, and that will increase the ticks score of every player. So now the tick score becomes higher and higher, but that's not what we want. So we're going to set it back to 0, but only when it's higher than 10. So now the tick score becomes higher and higher, until it reaches 10, and then it will go back to 0, and it will do that over and over again. Now we will tell these teleport commands to only teleport a player when his tick score is 0. That way the player will only be teleported once every 10 ticks. And now we can adjust the delay very easily. We can make the tick score go back to 0 when it's 20, for example. That way the player is only teleported once every 20 ticks. So what we'll do, we'll make the delay shorter or longer, depending on the current speed. That's what these command blocks are for. This one sets the tick score to 0 when the speed is 1 and the tick score is 10. This one sets the tick score to 0 when the speed is 2 and the tick score is 9, and so on and so on. So now we can move in any direction with a custom speed. Good, now let's add some particles and sound. This command will display smoke particles at the position of all players with a speed higher than 1. And these command blocks will play a pig sound, but the pitch is different for every speed there is. Now the XP bar is pretty easy. It just removes all the XP and then it will give you XP again, and the amount of XP depends on your speed. And all we have to do now is give the player the ability to adjust the speed. That's what these command blocks are for. This one tests if the player selects the first slot. When he does, this clock starts running, and this clock increases the speed. When the player selects the second slot, this clock will start running, and that decreases the speed. And this clock is there just in case the player doesn't select any of the two slots. This clock also decreases the speed. As you can see, the clocks all have a different delay. This way, it takes a while before your speed is 10, but when you want to stop, you can do that almost immediately. If you want to see this in an actual minigame, there's a server called Mineplex that uses this as a minigame, and that's where I got the idea from. There's one downside, you can actually walk through blocks. Yeah. No, stop, no, what?